has shown a copy of the video to Kingston Police, and a spokesperson has said that it could be looked into, but no statement or explanation of the use of force has been received by our deadline.
Rebel says she was shocked by what she witnessed. Very disgusted, and it was sickening, and it just made me sick to my stomach.
Rebel says she couldn't see what led to the altercation, and admits police may have been justified in using force. It's the amount of force used by police that Rebel questions.
I don't know what happened. It was just my opinion that it was a little bit excessive with what he was with the officer.
Surfaced on the same day Kingston Police released their annual use of force statistics, which showed overall a slight decrease. Darren Davis, Local News, Kingston.
To Police Chief Neil DuBord and his wife Lorraine are being sued. The BC Supreme Court lawsuit comes nearly 2 years after an incident outside their Centennial Beach home.
The lawsuit was filed because was a lack of a sense of justice being accomplished through the criminal system.
Richmond teacher Karen Sadu said she was caught by a quickly rising tide, forcing her to climb the rocks outside their house and touch their fence. She said Lorraine DuBord taunted her about her weight, then sprayed her with a hose.
She said, "I should spray you with my hose." And I said, "That would be assault." Like, I very clearly said that to her. And she went got her hose and sprayed me in the face.
Sadu's friends then confronted Lorraine DuBord.
That is assault. That head put the hose and turned the hose on.
The civil claim alleges the act was racially motivated. The lawsuit lists the plaintiff's injuries as general and aggravated, emotional distress, injury to feelings and dignity, and anxiety and long-term psychological. It seeks damages including for pain and suffering, loss of earnings, and loss of income earning capacity.
WCB recognizes bullying, and bullying is defined as harassment and intimidation. And when we look at what Ms. Sadu encountered, it's her allegation that that was a form of harassment and intimidation.
An RCMP investigation recommended an assault charge against Lorraine DuBord. Prosecutors chose alternative measures, an option sometimes allowed if a person accepts responsibility and makes amends. So far, the DuBords have not responded to the lawsuit. Catherine Urquhart, Global News.
Cop watch. To the ground, to the ground, to the ground. He's gathered around an elderly woman at Hastings and Abbott. Then a man appears to question police about how they're dealing with her. That's when an officer shoves the man.
Shoved him to the ground.
To the ground. To the ground. Now, 11 months later.
Police tyranny at its finest, guys.
Shoved him to the ground.
that evidence?
Following a complaint, a use of force investigation was conducted by the VPD under the direction of the Office of the Police Complaint Commissioner. It found the complaint unsubstantiated.
There were six officers or maybe more on site, so I find it hard to believe that nothing was documented and how this... They knew the video existed.
No particular reason why you've waited this long to post it.
I've always wanted there to be an investigation. I just felt that it needed to get to the right person first.
Nielsen says Vancouver police have never followed up with him, noting he's a volunteer on the downtown east side and easily locatable.
To date, I've not had one officer reach out to obtain a statement. I also did stay on scene after the initial incident in the fall, and I never once was asked for my name.
In response to that, the VPD says attempts were made to locate the man by his nickname, but they were unsuccessful. The OPCC says it continues to review the case, and the video could prompt further investigation by an external agency. Catherine Urquhart.